have to show you the very beginning. So take a look at this. We'll come back with Rick just a moment.
前面特朗普政府跟我们打贸易战，那么我们为什么搞不定特朗普政府啊？为什么以前1992年到2016年之间，中美之间各种问题都能搞得定，是不是？大家发现没有？所有的危机，不管是银河号事件，还是炸大使馆，还是撞了飞机，所有事情全部是床头吵架，床尾和，2个月之内搞定。什么原因？啊，这儿我抛出一个可能又要是暴论了。
Okay, we didn't get to set that. I didn't get to set that up for you. Very disturbing story aired last night about the U.S. relationship with China is on Fox News with Tucker Carlson. It involves this professor you just saw from Beijing. We played this morning. So many of you had comments about it. While speaking on a TV show, now this was in late November, about 10 days ago, he talked about the Wall Street corporate types and international trade. His specialty is international trade. The video has reportedly been deleted from Chinese social media right after it was uploaded. His name is Dai Dong Shin, and he's saying why the U.S. and China have had a good relationship from 1992 to 2016. But we're in a trade war now, he says, with the Trump administration, and he talks about why we can't fix it. Now, I hope you were paying attention to the subtitles on that, and he said that they used to be able to fix any issue we had with America in about 2 months. He says it's because we have people at the top, is what he said in that. And Rick, the reason I'm bringing this up is because I've wondered, like you, what's wrong with our legislators. I've wondered, like you, what's wrong in Georgia with the governor of Georgia. He's talking about America. Now, this is a possibility. Are these people compromised? He goes on to say, those people are at the top of America's core inner circle of power and influence. At one point, he even talks about an American woman who works as an agent for the Chinese. She was an American, but now is a Chinese citizen. He says the American agent worked on successful propaganda campaigns in Washington, D.C. 2015. He will go on to say this, now listen to this, that Obama administration was easy to manipulate. Now, who was the vice president during the Obama administration? They were easy to manipulate, and they used Wall Street to make that happen. But he says it all changed when Donald Trump took over. Now, I'm going to play you clip two, and I want you to read the subtitles as the man talks. He's an expert. Watch this.
其实呢，就过去这个30年啊，过去40年，我们在美国的它的这个利用它权势核心圈，是不是？我前面讲过，华尔街在1970年代开始对美国它的内政外交有非常强的影响力啊，所以我们有路径依赖，是吧？但问题是，08年之后华尔街的地位下降了，更重要的是16年之后，华尔街搞不定特朗普。 为什么很尴尬？特朗普以前对华尔街有维持软性违约，所以双方有矛盾啊。当然，这个细节我就不多说了，时间可能已经来不及了，是吧？那么，这个中美贸易战过程中，他们也试图帮忙啊。据我所知，美方的朋友跟我讲，这个试图帮忙，但是啊，力有不逮啊。但现在呢，现在我们看到拜登上台了。
He says, now, did you hear what he said there? But now we see Biden was elected. And essentially, he's saying, it's time to get back to business with America's ruling elite. This is what Chang says. He then comments about none other than Hunter Biden. Watch the words at the bottom of the screen. Go ahead.
拜登的儿子被特朗普说，你在全球有什么基金公司，发现没有？谁帮他建的基金公司啊？明白吗？
这边都有买卖啊。Did you see that? He's insinuating that China helped Hunter Biden. Now, you didn't see those stories on the corporate media. Essentially, what he's saying, China has a relationship with Hunter Biden. Now, what does that have to do with Georgia and all the other things? Well, we saw another video. We saw some more things concerning the thing with Georgia. If that wasn't enough, the next video I want to show you is a little more disturbing. No, that's not that. I want to show you that video. I want to show you the governor right here. Lawyer Lynn Wood drew some tainted attention to Georgia's Governor Brian Kemp in a tweet he shared with us on Monday. Now look at this. It begins to circle that with social media that Georgia has a Chinese website. Georgia has a Chinese website that entices Georgia-owned businesses to take residence in the Peach State. Governor Kemp is seen on the website touting the relationship with Chinese businesses and how much they like to have them in Georgia. There's his picture. He's standing in front of the communist flag of China. Wood says it's no coincidence that Georgia has China ties and how the election results have panned out there. So does this seem far-fetched, Rick, or is this a plausible connection to why so many of our elected officials, either they don't know the Constitution, I'll give you that, but maybe in some ways they're compromised too with the economic war that's been going on between the United States and China?
Yeah, you know, a lot of people have said from the beginning the whole Trump derangement syndrome was just because of his personality, right? That people hated Trump because of his personality. It's the same old thing we've always said, follow the money. The hatred of Trump, even from the campaign during 2016, is because he said from the beginning he was going to take on China. He was willing to take on this powerhouse that has been investing in, I mean, in virtually everything you can imagine in America, not just in governments and in businesses, you name it, and he was willing to stand against them. And so throughout his administration, because he's done that, they've hated him and been after him. It's actually the most dangerous part of a Joe Biden presidency, because frankly, the presidency's most important job is the foreign relations around the country and foreign policy, not so much domestic. Now, granted, Biden's terrible on domestic, and we've got issues that, you know, gun control and all kinds of things we're gonna have to fight. But it's the fact that the whole Biden, the whole Hunter Biden scandal being literally censored and kept from the American people even knowing that. We know now with the polling data afterwards that about 17% of Biden supporters would have voted against Biden and for Trump if they had known about the Hunter Biden scandal or one of any of eight other or seven other issues. This is the nail on the head. Now, whether or not, I mean, that looks pretty strong to me and pretty damning to me, whether or not Kemp and a lot of these local officials, that's the reason that they've been spineless, or it's just their own political interest, or they want to continue to keep the money flowing in the right direction, who knows? But we sure know biblically we're to judge people not by their titles, not by their party, but by their fruit. And the fruit right now says that an awful lot of people that should be siding with America are siding with Chinese interest and siding with what's best for China in the long run rather than what's best for America. It's why already we hear Biden and his administration, the type of people that he would put in place if he does win this thing, they want to get rid of the America First slogans because they're not about making America first. They will undermine everything that Trump has done for the last 4 years to put us on such a powerful front. Okay, you know, these are not far-fetched conspiracy theories. We see the evidence right in front of us.